That's sin. He's saying that if you get married, it ain't wrong. This is how I'm choosing to rock.
Right.
And if a virgin marry, she had not sinned. Nevertheless, such shall have trouble in the flesh, but I spare you. That's the whole, you know, it's better to marry, not to burn, all that. But this I say, brethren, the time is short. It remained that both they that have wives be as though they had none. No matter what, the time is short. You're not here forever. You got to live holy no matter what. It goes on to say, and they that weep as though they wept not, and they that rejoice as though they rejoice not, and they that buy as though they possess not. Time is running short. And they that use this world as not abusing it, for the fashion of this world passeth away. But I would have you without carefulness, he that is unmarried, carry for the things that belong to the Lord, how he may please the Lord. This is what Paul is saying. When you stay unmarried, you can fully focus on God, nothing else. But if you marry, you got to deal with that woman. 34 says, there is a difference between a wife and a virgin. The unmarried woman cares for the things of the Lord, that she may be holy both in the body and in spirit. Watch this, because sex before marriage is a sin. So that's what he's speaking of. Then he says, but she that is married cares for the things of the world, how she may please her husband. Because at this point, your ministry is your family. You got to take care of your
family. This is the key, bro. He's saying that if you pleasing your wife, this is not godly. He's saying if you pleasing your wife, it's the thing of the world. It's worldly. That's not
what Paul is saying. He's bringing balance. He's being very balanced.
Read it again.
Okay, so think about all the scriptures that I just read above.
Verse
33. He's going back and forth, right? He's saying he's talking to married people and he's talking to unmarried people. So 33 says, that started 32. 32 says, but I would have you without carefulness, he that is unmarried, carry for the things that belong to the Lord, how he may please the Lord.
Single devotion.
Paul is saying that because Paul is again with being married.
Right.
Then he says, 33, but he that is married, care for the things that are of the world, how he may please his wife.
Exactly.
Because when you choose to have a wife and kids, that's your first ministry. You can't sit in church all day. You can't be traveling all across the world on a great commission and leaving your family, because what the scriptures say, a man that don't take care of his family is worse than an infidel.
Right.
That's
the things of the world. It's a worldly thing to be married.
But keep in mind, that's why Paul says, before he started in all this, think about what Paul said. Paul says, now concerning virgins, I have no commandment of the Lord, yet I give my judgment. Then he goes on to say, this is all Paul. This is not God. This is all Paul talking about. If you're going to be married, you good. You can run with God. If you're not going to be married, man, you got to run with your family.
So none of this is inspired by God right now that we read.
This is all inspired by God. Because
I thought you said it was Paul. No.
This is Paul's words. But Paul is still being inspired by God, because Paul is saying that, listen, I don't want to be married because I want to run with God. Period. I don't want to have to do nothing. I don't want to have to make love to no woman. I don't want to have to talk to no woman. I don't want to have to put no roof over her head. None of that. Every day I wake up, I want to go with God.
So the only way that you can serve God with single devotion is to be single. That's what he's saying, right? Because the woman is a distraction. She's concerned about the things of the world. So that's going to be a conflict with you trying to serve God. That's what he's saying.
100, but let's be careful. Like when you use, like think about this, right? The word distraction is not the word ignorance. It has negative connotations depending on how you use it. The word ignorance simply means not knowing. That's what it means. But we use it as an insult, right?
But it's just a conflict. The woman is... See, the Bible says he who finds a wife finds a good thing. But now, Paul says it's not a good thing. Yeah, but Paul ain't saying that. He's saying that this woman is going to cause you to be concerned with the things of the world, and it's going to present a conflict between you and God.
Because think about this, right? You're doing your show. Imagine if your woman was just beating on the door. Like, man, boy, you can bring it up for 2 hours and 30 minutes, man. What is you doing? That's a distraction. Now watch this. You ain't doing nothing wrong. You're not in no strip club right now. You're not playing Madden for 2 hours. Like, you having an intellectual discussion in your home. Right. But she still can be a... Now, forget your woman. Your kid can be beating on the door right now. The kids want to see her daddy. Right. But that's a... If that kid didn't exist, guys, I don't know if you have kids, but you're not, you know...
No.
Okay, well, cool, cool. If that kid didn't exist, then guess what? You ain't got to worry about nobody beating on your door. Whatsoever. But my dog, while I'm having this discussion... My dog had texted me like 4 times. I had the answer, daddy coming, daddy coming.
Yeah.
She's a distraction.
See, that single devotion, it takes away from that single devotion to God. That's what Paul is saying. Because you can't love the things of the world. You can't be a friend of the world. Jesus says that the cares of the world chokes out the word. So
out the word.
That's right. A big thing people miss, and they don't preach this in church.
That's right.
But when you marry, what the conflict is going to present between you and God.
Well, they actually do teach this in church now, in real churches. My pastor, the pastor Dwayne Johnson, Bishop Lester Love, my pastor right now, Juan Martinez, and Get Rap. Now he does preach that. You need to take care of your family. Yeah. If you chose to have a family, your family is your first ministry. You cannot be at this church every time them daggone doors open. You better take the woman on a date. You better take them kids to go to the park and go be a dad. That's not sin. That's why Paul said, if you choose to get married, it ain't sin.
But now I'm saying they don't preach that being married is a worldly thing. Like, married to a woman, that's not a God. God is worldly.
It is God, and we gotta be careful, because God says, the Bible says, he that finds a wife find a good thing and obtaineth favor from the Lord. Obtaineth favor from the Lord. So God is getting married is a beautiful thing. That's why, think about Adam and Eve.
So was Eve, I'm glad you said that. Was Eve a good thing to Adam?
Absolutely. He said it's not good for man to be alone.
No, but what did Adam say about Eve? He said, the woman you gave me, she messed up everything. But watch this.
When God, watch this. The government of God. Hey, the man is the head. That's why God never talked to Eve at all. He talked to Adam. Like, homie, I don't care what that woman did. The woman is the weaker vessel. That's what scripture says. I told you, I gave you these commandments. I told you, do not touch that tree. That's in the middle of God. You're supposed to stand on business because you're a man. You're the head, you're not the tail. Adam chose not to stand on business. And so now when he said this woman, that was him copping out. That was a cop out. He could easily told her no the same way he told her yes.